Today, let's see how we can reparameter. Today, let's see how we can reparameterize. Today, let's see how we can reparameterize. 再次. We are going to see how to reparameterize this factor function r of t with respect to the r length from the point 1, 0 to t. So, to get the r length, I'm going to use this version s of t, because we want to end up with t. This version is we have to integrate, and I will just put down the magnitude of r prime of, well, because we want to end up with t, so I will have to use the dummy variable here. Let me put down u like this. And then we will be in the u world, and we will have to figure out for what t value will give us this initial point. So I'm just going to set the x component to be that. So that's 2 over t squared plus 1 minus 1 to be this one. And you can just look at it real quick, and usually you get 0 because the questions are not that bad sometimes. You know? And you should also check the y values right here. That's 2t over t squared plus 1 equal to 0. And yes, yeah. So that's for sure. So that means u will start at this 0 and then go up to this t. So that's the general idea. And another version for the r length is you just do the square root and then the x component derivative, you know, and then square that and all that stuff, but same thing. This right here is more compact and shorter, but the amount of work is the same. Anyways, let's go ahead and get the derivative first. Okay, to differentiate this, let me just put this on the side. We write this as 2 and then times t squared plus 1 raised to a negative 1 power. Put a negative to the front, so we have negative 2. The inside stays minus 1, and then multiply by the derivative inside because of the chain rule. So that will give us negative 4t over t squared plus 1 squared. And then the derivative of minus 1 is 0, doesn't matter. Okay, and then we add, for this derivative, we will have to use the quotient rule. So I'm going to square the bottom. And then the bottom 1 times the derivative of the top, which is just 2, minus the top function times the derivative of the bottom. And then perhaps we'll clean this up a little bit. 2t squared plus 2 minus 4t squared. So together we have negative, let me just put on, oh, I have plus over there already. Minus 2t squared and then plus 2. And then don't forget the denominator. And you can kind of feel like, okay, the denominators are the same. So that's kind of cool. Next, we have to get the magnitude. Take the magnitude, we open a square root, and we're going to square that, and combine them. So negative 4t over t squared plus 1 squared, and square that, and we add this thing, negative 2t squared plus 2, and then we square that. Okay. The denominators is the same, so I'm just going to combine them. And the top right here is the following, right? So that will give us positive 16t squared. And then we are going to add, okay, this thing squared, we have a negative. When we square that, we get positive. So that's 4t to the fourth power. And then we have to subtract, because that's a negative, so this is subtract. And then just this times that, but I have a subtraction already. 2 times this and that. So 2 times this is 4, and then times that is 8. And then t squared, and that's the this thing squared, so plus 4. And then all over. That thing, so t squared plus 1 squared. Square, so it's to the fourth power. Okay, and then let's see what we can do. This and that can be combined, and that's going to be, the inside is 4t to the fourth power plus 8t squared plus 4. Yes, and then we can factor out 4, and then t to the 4 plus 2t squared plus 1. So we can factor the top as follows. We have the square root, the 4, and then this thing is just t squared plus 1 squared, and then over t squared plus 1 to the fourth power. Sometimes cancellations will happen, this and that cancel, we have 2. So square root of 4 is 2, over the bottom is just nicely t squared plus 1. So that is pretty nice. And now we just have to go ahead and integrate. S of t is going to be the integral, and we go from 0 to t, and then we'll just put this thing here, so that will be 2 over, remember we are going to use u for the dummy variable, and then it will be in the u world like this. And then just go ahead and do this real quick. You will get 2 inverse tangent of u, and then plug in t, and you just have 2 inverse tangent of t, yeah, and then plug in 0, you get 0. So that's what we have. So that's s of t. And then of course, you don't need to write down the s of t, we can just write down s. Because now we see, I will still put down s of t. Because now we can say s is just equal to 2 inverse tangent of t, divide 2 on both sides, and then take the original tangent on both sides. So we can see t is equal to the original tangent of s over 2. All right, so that is our t in terms of s. So r, no longer t because I'm going to put down this right here. So it'll be r of s. Yeah, so that will be equal to 2 over t is that, so tangent s over 2, and then we square that, and then minus 1. Oh, sorry, plus 1 right here, and then here's a minus 1. You might be wondering why is there a minus 1? You're going to see. And then we add 2, and then the t is this, which is tangent s over 2, and then over again, tangent s over 2, and then we square that plus 1, and then j. Oops. Okay, now have a look. Tangent of an angle squared plus 1. Let me remind you guys this right here. Tangent squared theta plus 1. This is nicely equal to what? Secant squared theta. All right, so that's a very nice cancellation. So let's do this in our head. We have secant squared theta on the bottom. Let's bring that up so it becomes cosine squared theta. So we have 2 and this thing. I'm just going to write this, cosine square, and the theta is s over 2. All right, and then no more plus 1 because the whole thing is that. And then after that we have a minus 1, and I forgot the I right here because we're talking about r of s. That's still a factor function like this. So that's the first component at the moment, and then we are going to add. Okay, here same thing, we have secant square s over 2 on the bottom, and I'm going to do this. This right here is 2. For this right here, I'm going to write it as sine of s over 2 over cosine of s over 2. And then this thing on the bottom, I'm going to multiply that, bring that up, and then that would be cosine square of s over 2. And you can see some nice cancellation again. This and that cancel, and we still have one of them. And that's in the j component. Okay, now, okay, let me just remind you guys more identities. This right here is actually from a, depends on how you want to look at, it's double angle identity. Here we go. I'm gonna write it like this. If we have cosine of 2 theta, one of the versions for this right here is equal to 2 cosine square theta minus 1. That's why we have that negative 1. Because now you can see we can look at this backwards. Theta is s over 2. Yeah. So in fact, you can see The first component is just going to be cosine of 2 times this angle, but that's s over 2, so the 2 will cancel. So we have cosine of s. Right? The whole thing is that, and then that's in the I component. And then this and that cancel, but of course, here we have what? If you look at sine of 2 theta, that is 2 sine theta times cosine theta. And again, we're just going to look at this backwards. We have 2 sine of this angle, cosine of that angle. So together it's just sine of 2 theta. So we are just really adding sine of 2 times s over 2. Well, the 2's cancel again. So it's sine of s. And then in the j component, just like that. So in fact, if you look at this, s is greater than 0, and you can see that this is actually just a circle. So that thing is actually a circle.